are looking at three current trends that you need to watch out for in 2023. And we want to see if we can recreate these on Canva. Thanks to creativeblog.com by Patrick Llewellyn. I'll link the blog on the description below. The first one that we're going to look at is the loosely interpreted letter marks. And we want to see if we can recreate this on Canva. You know, design has no right or wrong. It is you going out there and being bold and being creative and coming up with new ways that you can interpret your work to the world. So with this new Nokia design, the question is, can we reinterpret this and do it on Canva? To give you an inspiration when you're coming up with design and you're designing for your clients, you can use this trends on your logo designs. So I went in on Canva and I created a canvas and I added an N and I used the 29LT Bakra font. What I want you to take away from here is, if you are searching for fun and creative fonts, you need to go on the search functionality and you need to choose with the menu option that's available there. So with the modern menu, this is where I found this 29LT Bakra font that looks very suspicious like the Nokia font. It's close. I'm not saying it's the same, but it's very close. In order for us to interpret the Nokia font that's loosely interpreted and funky and exciting, we typed an N and their N is half cut. You know, with Canva, you always need to come up with a clever way or creative way of redoing stuff on Canva. Please watch out for my next video if you've been watching my videos for a while, because we need to start graduating from just Canva and start using tools that can give us more in terms of designs. With our rectangle that we've added, we're going to change the color and make it white, and then we're going to bring it front so that it's cutting the N that way. Next, you're going to duplicate your N and you're going to type an O. The O looks almost the same, so you're going to duplicate the O and you're going to type the K. And with the K, because it's a loosely interpreted letter marks, we want to duplicate the shape that we already have, cover the K, but it needs to have that edge at the back, so you're going to move it to almost the end so that you have that pointy edge like that. Group the two and then align them to your O and select them and send them to back, and then duplicate the O to create your I. I is easy, right? And then duplicate the I to create your A. Duplicate the rectangle shape and then cover your A. And there's the loosely interpreted letter mark. What are we saying here? We're saying these trends that people like to see for their new business that they are starting out. If Canva is the only tool that can help you get to what is trending and get you more business, then by all means, jump in on the trend, get excited with what's going out there, and then create. Trend is the distorted fonts trend. I love this. The rock and roll logo is redone and it looks like it's rocking and rolling. And the only way that you could do this if you were using Canva is if you use the new tool that Canva has added that's called Typecraft. So what you would do on Typecraft, you would distort the text that you're adding. So you would type your rock, you would pick the font that you want, pick the color that you also want, and then if the font is huge, you could always press reset shape and it brings it to a smaller size. And if you want to start making it a little bit big, you start making it like that and you are distorting the text to whichever way that you want. When you want to reset, you reset. If you want to add the text to your design, you're going to click add to design. Once it's added to element, you can continue distorting and making it square and rounded. This is the only way on Canva that I know how that you can distort text on Canva. Then you just update your text and it distorts it to whichever way that you want. That's why if you're watching for the first time, Canva is the best place to start. But the next best tool would either be Photoshop or Adobe Illustrator, because these tools like Photopea and Photoshop, they have distort tools that you could use and make the text exactly the way that you want when you are using them. So if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I'm going to be creating a lot more for a little more advanced learner. I'm still going to take care of my basic learners, the beginners, but we need to graduate and do more and do better. So for now, distort and using Typecraft is awesome way to distort text that you are creating and creating amazing logos for your clients. The last trend is the acidic hues. What is acidic hues? These are hues that are neon colors, colorful, funky, and eye-grabbing. These are currently trending, and when you're creating different kinds of logos, share them with your clients and then show them that this is the, you are the SME, you are the subject matter expert as the designer, and you can show them that this is currently trending, and big companies like Bolt are changing their color hues to go in line with what's currently trending. So I wanted to just show you, can we get these acidic hues colors on Canva? Absolutely. The different hex codes that you could be using, when you're adding your color, you could type your hex code there. You could also search for it down at the bottom. So I'm going to link a couple of these colorful hex acidic hues so that you have them, like this one and this one, and so on and so forth. So you could be creating and adding these to your bag of tricks for when you're creating logos and any other designers that catches the eye on social media as well. You could get clients that are seeing exactly what everybody is doing in your design space, and they would love what you do. If you enjoy these videos, please consider subscribing. Thank you so much for joining me on this video today. I will see you on our next video.